Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. About 8 years ago, I made a video tutorial on the GPS logger app, which is available for Android phones. Since then, the interface of the app has undergone some changes, and I thought it would be helpful to take a fresh look at the app and document these changes through a new video. The GPS logger app is a great app that can be used to conduct field surveys. It can record waypoints and tracks just like a handheld Garmin GPS receiver. It also permits you to export these waypoints and tracks in GPX, KML, and CSV formats that can be uploaded on a GPS device, displayed on Google Earth, or imported in any GIS application. As you can see, it is completely free, it has no ads, it collects no user data, and shares nothing with any third party. In a world that many refer to as being driven by surveillance capitalism, this privacy-respecting app is a truly remarkable offering. I compliment the developers, Basic Air Data, for this awesome app and hope that they continue to support it in the future. With that little background out of the way, let's now dive in and see how to record and export waypoints and tracks using GPS logger. So the first thing that you want to do is to head outdoors and find a location that has a clear, unobstructed view of the sky. And then just simply switch on the GPS or location in your smartphone and then start your GPS logger app. So within a few seconds of starting your app, you should see a screen like this, which shows you an initial fix. You should stand out in the open for about a minute to make sure that the signal is stabilized. Keep an eye on the number of satellites that are being acquired and the accuracy. And within the initial minute, you should have an acceptable level of accuracy to proceed. So when you start this app, you're going to see three tabs on top. The first one is GPS fix, the second one is track, and the third one is track list. The GPS fix tab shows you all information about your current location in latitude, longitude. It shows you the time, it shows you the number of satellites that it has been tracking, shows you your altitude, if you are walking or driving, your current speed in kilometers per hour. It can also show you in miles per hour if you set it that way. And then it's also showing you the accuracy, currently 12 meters. It can improve much further. The second one is track. So this is where we record all our placemarks and tracks. We'll come to this in a second. And once we have recorded and saved our placemarks, etc., the third tab is track list. This is where they land up. So currently you are seeing three tracks or place marks that I have recorded. When you tap on any one of these, you see a number of icons on top. If you click on the first eye icon, you can see the point or track on any app that you have installed, Google Earth in my case. And then the second icon on top is the pencil icon. So if you tap on the pencil icon, you can change the name of the track. In this particular case, for example, I can just come here and call it my house, and you can see that the name has changed. The line on top is showing you the date of the recording. So in this particular case, 2025 in the month of July, date 27th. And then finally, the time on which it was recorded. So 7:41 a.m. 14 seconds. So this will be time of recording. If you click on the share tab and share this particular location or track with any compatible apps like Mail, etc. And if you tap on this once again, the last one is basically, it exports your track or placemark in KML or in GPX format, which can be set by clicking on settings and then coming down. And you can see it is exporting to text, GPX, and KML. So currently, I have set KML and GPX. So whenever this button is pressed, you select a particular track and this button is pressed, it is saved in those two formats. You can set the folder where the downloaded files will finally land up by going to settings and then just simply changing the folder in the local exportation folder setting. I'll take you through the settings a little while later. So let's see how to record tracks and placemarks. To record a track or placemark, just tap on the track tab. And let's say we want to record some placemarks. We are walking on the beach and we want to record some nesting sites for turtles. Come across the first nesting site. So to record that site, we will just tap on the annotate icon and then give that particular site a name. In this particular case, I'm calling it nest one and add. So you see one point has been added. We walk some more, come across a second nest site. So we can record it by tapping the annotate button once again. Give it a name, nest two, and add. So the second has been recorded. We walk a little further, come across a third nesting site. So tap annotate once again. Give it a name, nest three, for example. We can add more points like this. And to finish the track, we can just press on the stop button and then just simply give that particular set of placemarks a name. So I'm going to call it turtle nesting site. And once we have given the name, we can just press OK. So once the placemarks have been recorded, they appear on the track list tab. Just tap on it and you can see the placemarks right on top. As you tap on it, you can then click on the eye icon to see the placemarks on Google Earth. What you see on the screen is just a representative example of how the placemarks would appear when they are viewed on Google Earth. And as we have mentioned before, you can always click on the download button and download the waypoints and tracks as GPX or KML files and use them in any GPS device or GIS or any other mapping application. Now that we have seen how to record waypoints or placemarks, let's now see how we can record tracks in the GPS Logger app. So just like placemarks, to record a track, you need to come to the Tracks tab, as you can see now on the screen. So to record a track, all you need to do is to just press the record button. And as you can see, a track is being recorded as I start walking. Points are being automatically collected. And notice that the overall general direction of travel is west. Now it's possible that after a little distance, you want to stop or pause the track and record a milestone. So just press the pause button and then press the annotate button and enter the milestone, in this particular case 3, and press add. So one annotation has been added and we restart the recording and the track is continuing now. So we are moving forward. About 74 points have been collected. We want to put another milestone, so we press the pause button, press annotate and enter the second milestone name, in this particular case trail forks here, and then press add, and then press the record button once again to continue recording our track. So as we are moving forward, you will see more and more points are being collected. And we stop once again to record a third annotation, a third milestone. In this particular case, I'm recording a fire tar as I'm moving in my track. Press add, and then press record again. And we are moving forward, and our track is now getting recorded. We have already done three annotations and now we want to stop. So just press the pause button, then the stop button, and give this track a name. So I'm just calling this a field transect, as you can see, and press OK. And this track has been recorded. We can now press the track list and you can see right on the top, the field transect has actually been recorded, showing you the shape of the track, the line. And you can tap on it and then you can see it inside Google Earth using the eye symbol or press edit or do whatever you want. You can see that there is a little man walking icon on top, and this icon is basically indicating that the track was completed walking. If you are recording this track in your vehicle like driving, you would see a car icon instead. You can change this icon by tapping on this particular track and then pressing edit and then choosing an icon of your choice if you wanted to. You will also notice that there's a lot of information about the track itself. The length of the track, 137 meters, the max speed that was gained while completing this track, the duration of the recording, the average speed, the number of points in this track, and the number of annotations in this particular track. So a lot of information about the track that has been recorded right here in front of you on the track list page. So I briefly mentioned about changing icons on any track that you have saved. So all you need to do is to just tap on the track and then tap on the pencil icon right above, the edit icon. And here you will see a big bouquet of icons, and you can choose any icon that you want. And that icon will then be displayed on your track. Let me now quickly show you the settings. So to access settings, just tap on the three dots on the top right and then tap on settings. So there are a lot of settings that you can use here, and some of them are really very obvious. So systems of measurement is one of the settings that many people would like to choose depending on where they are from. And then you can also tap on show speeds in to choose your speed unit. Then you can scroll down and choose to show your coordinates in decimal degrees through this setting. I have already told you about the local exportation folder. This is where all your exported files will go. Now, we were recording tracks at certain intervals, so that interval can be changed from here. And the default is 1 second, but you can choose 2 seconds, 3 seconds, depending upon how frequently you want to record track points. When you come down, you see a very important setting here, that is EGM 96 correction. So if you switch this on, it downloads geoid height points. And once this is on, you get a very accurate estimate of altitude. Accurate altitude correction is one of the highlights of this app. Finally, you can see the exportation section where you can set what formats you would like your tracks to be exported in. So currently you can see I have switched on all three, comma separated values, GPX and KML, but you can choose whatever you want. So you can explore these settings and you will find them that they give you very granular control on what you can do with this app. So that's the GPS Logger app in summary. I hope this video helps you get started on the GPS Logger app. It's a wonderful app to have on your phone. So that's it for this video. Many thanks for watching.